Upon everything was a haze of restlessness and oppression, a touch of the unreal and the grotesque, as if some vital element of perspective or curious guru were awry. I did not wonder that the foreigners would not stay, for this was no region to sleep in. It was too much like a landscape of Salvator Rosa, too much like some forbidden woodcut in a tale of terror. Hello, and welcome to the Eldridge Collection. My name is Aaron Peterson, and I will be your curator. Today, we're talking about Salvator Rosa and his work, Witches at Their Incantations. For last week's video, where I did a review of Color Out of Space by Richard Stanley, I did some prep work by rereading the original short story by H.P. Lovecraft, and I was struck by the reference of Salvator Rosa in the original description of the area in which the story is set. So, out of curiosity, I decided to look at some of his works. I learned that Salvator Rosa was an Italian Baroque painter, and he lived from 1615 to 1673. It appears that he is better known for his landscapes and for inspiring future artists, specifically those artists well known in the Romantic period, especially from Italy. His landscapes often include ruins, bandits, witches, dark, interesting places, and a lot of complex uses of shadow and light that are obviously a precursor to a lot of themes found in future Romantic paintings. Personally, Romantic paintings are some of my favorite. Though, for this channel, and for my own dark heart, I was particularly captured by one of his paintings in particular, Witches at Their Incantations. Here's a description of the piece from the National Gallery in London. Beneath a pitch-dark sky, bizarre and terrifying magical spells are being cast. Monstrous figures, some of them naked, are arranged as if on a stage set, illuminated by scattered pools of light. In the center, one witch smokes the corpse of a criminal that hangs from a withered tree, while her companion cuts its toenails. In front of them, naked witches use a wax effigy to cast a love spell. Another, surrounded by a catalog of magical aids, stirs a cauldron. On the extreme left, two men exhume a corpse and force it to sign a document, while away to the right, a swaddled infant is held above the gaping jaws of a monster. This macabre scene evokes a witch's Sabbath, a gathering where the devil was worshipped. Salvator Rosa developed an interest in the supernatural while working in Florence in the 1640s, and probably painted this remarkable picture around 1646. I don't know if I could say it much better than that. It is an incredibly dark and fascinating picture. This painting captures a lot of imagery that is, of course, classic when you're thinking about witches. You know, their nakedness, their misshapen forms, their use of cauldrons and spells, but the items on the periphery of this painting are pieces that are particularly interesting to me. For instance, the dusk that remains to the far left of the painting, where there's just a little bit of orange and red still left in the sky before it becomes completely night, has captured some of the most profound vistas that I've seen, and some of the most interesting clouds I've seen move across the night sky. And it's haunting, and it captures my attention, even if it is just a small detail in the corner. As the National Gallery references, the two men forcing the corpse to sign a document is interesting because it calls into profound questions about agency and the afterlife, which is something that's not discussed with other witchly practices and, you know, sort of stereotypical ideas that you associate with witches and their spells. It's a fascinating concept that kind of threw me off guard, and I definitely appreciate it. And the element of this painting that I enjoy the most is the strange skeletal bird monster on the other side of the painting. I definitely appreciate the eldritch, mysterious qualities of this undead monstrosity, and it's fascinating to think of the imagination of someone all the way back in the 1640s coming up with something so profoundly dark, and I appreciate that it was actually committed to painting and preserved for this time. Unfortunately, this painting is not on display, and also the National Gallery is closed right now due to COVID-19. But you can go to the National Gallery's website and see a very detailed image of it and take your time zooming in and pulling out and really getting a chance to appreciate all the details that Rosa put into this painting. I can see why H.P. Lovecraft was influenced by his work, especially when coming up with tales of terror himself. If you would like to support the collection, it's simple. All you need to do is hit like, subscribe, and share this video with anyone you think would appreciate dark art and weird fiction. Thank you, and I'll see you next time.